Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning and I'm at one of the best rock climbing locations in the world, at Smith Rock in Oregon. Behind me is Smith Rock, which formed as the result of one of the largest volcanic explosions in Oregon's history. Smith Rock is part of the Crooked River Caldera, which is an enormous volcanic caldera that erupted between 29 and 30 million years ago, just once. The eruption that formed the Crooked River Caldera created about 200 cubic miles of tuff and volcanic material. And this left a crater between 15 and 25 miles wide, centered around the city of Prineville. Smith Rock forms the northwestern corner of this enormous caldera. A supervolcanic caldera eruption erupts from the fringes of the caldera, along what are called fissures. The ash and rock erupts out of these fissures as the magma chamber below empties out. As the magma chamber empties out, the ground above subsides and leaves a massive caldera. Smith Rock also exhibits features of being at the edge of a caldera because of large chunks of pumice and other surrounding rocks that the caldera blasted through. For example, a Permian Age limestone that probably forms the basement rock of this entire area. Smith Rock and the surrounding area are very jagged and contain a lot of spires of rock. This is because of differential erosion. Differential erosion is where different parts of a same rock mass erode at different rates. Different parts of the eruption were harder or softer, and that caused them to erode at different rates. A great example of differential erosion is this tall spire behind me. It is a rhyolitic lava intrusion that forced its way into Smith Rock long after the original eruption had cooled. Because it is a lot harder than the rock around it, it is left standing as a pinnacle as the Crooked River has eroded all around it, except at the very base. Smith Rock has been spectacularly eroded away by the Crooked River, which lies below. The Crooked River flows from high in the Ochoco Mountains and winds its way through volcanic rocks all the way to the end of Smith Rock here, which produced some of the many spires and pinnacles that make Smith Rock so dramatic. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning, thank you for watching.